The Pixel 2 is here, with quite a few changes from last year's model, and not all of them for the better. I got my hands on the kind of blue color, and included in the box we have the USB-C adapter and a dongle for those of you who like to complicate their music listening experience. I'll talk more about this in a second, but first, it's time to see how Google's new flagship and the theoretical king of all Android phones handles a durability test. Let's get started. I've tested over 70 different phones now on my channel, and most phones survive my tests. It's kind of fun to see how the different brands stack up next to each other, and see how each phone will hold up over the years that you own it. The scratch test is first. I have a set of mineral picks that show us what the screen is made out of. A plastic display like the Galaxy Active series would scratch at a level 3. This display is Gorilla Glass 5, so we should see scratching start at a level 6, with a deeper groove at a level 7. A pure sapphire screen like the HTC U Ultra Sapphire Edition would scratch at a level 8. The Pixel 2 scores the exact same as the iPhone 8 and the Galaxy S8 on the display scratch test, scratching at a level 6. Down at the bottom of the screen, embedded in the bezel, we have a large speaker grille for the front-firing speakers. This grille is made from metal, which is a step up from the white cloth grille of the original Pixel last year. The earpiece up at the top is built the exact same way. The metal grille sits pretty flush with the glass, so keeping it clean will be fairly easy. Remember that speakers have magnets in them that attract metal shavings, which can destroy speaker cones. So if you work around metal, keep your phone clear of those shavings. The front 8-megapixel camera is embedded under the same slab of Gorilla Glass 5, so it's protected against scratching. Something that is not impervious to scratching, though, is the back of the phone. It's kind of interesting to note that the word pixel is actually derived from the words picture element. Each individual pixel is just a small piece of the puzzle. You might have noticed that there's no metal-on-metal scratching sound that we've all come to love and enjoy during art class with Jerry, and that's because it's not metal that your skin is touching while holding the phone. On their website, Google has it worded as a water-resistant metal unibody, giving the vibe that you'll be touching metal. Most people probably missed it during the keynote as well, where they clarified a little bit more.
The all-aluminum body with a premium hybrid coating gives it a sleek and clean profile.
Their all-aluminum body has a premium hybrid coating, which is what you see scraping off here. There is metal that you can see under the coating, but that's not what your hand is touching. To me, the Pixel does not have the cold hard feel of metal, which is fine. I'm not opposed to plastic phones, it's just interesting that Google can't seem to decide what to call it either. They've said metal, hybrid coating, and then here deep in the tech specs on their website they call it paint, saying that it may chip if the phone is dropped, and also that leather or denim may transfer color onto the phone body. So it'll be interesting to see if you can actually carry this phone in your pocket or not. A case or skin might be mandatory. The volume rocker is made from metal, which is nice, but the colored button you see on this kind of blue version is made from plastic. We haven't seen plastic buttons on a phone for a while now. Once again, plastic isn't bad, it's just nice to know where it's at. Plastic does tend to warp more than metal does over time though. If you remember, as I mentioned earlier, plastic scratches at level 3 on most scale of hardness. And that's exactly what we're seeing here on the Pixel 2. It's pretty much the exact same situation as the LG G5 a few years ago. And my thoughts are that if it feels like plastic, why not just own it and make the phone plastic? Solid plastic wouldn't chip off or absorb colors like paint will. And it could also include wireless charging, which this phone does not have. The fingerprint is the same painted color as the back panel, but it has the same problem as the LG V30 durability test, where scratching the sensor renders it inoperable. The Pixel 2 tells me the sensor is dirty and that I need to clean it. Most phones still function with a scratch sensor, but this phone does not. Up here at the top of the phone, we have our single color LED flash covered in plastic. The plastic over the flash is normal. The camera lens is made from glass, which is great. I also like how the lens itself is not attached to the back glass panel. So if the phone is dropped, which does happen, the back glass housing might crack, but the camera lens itself is more likely to remain intact and undamaged, protected inside its metal housing. Thumbs up for that design change. I was able to switch out the back glass on the original Pixel to allow for other color combinations, and I'll attempt that again with the Pixel 2, but the easiest way to get the color you want and protect your phone is with the skin. The Pixel XL White and Black Panda Edition is sold out for weeks. Currently, you have to sit on a waiting list. This reverse panda from Dbrand looks pretty sweet, but the color options are pretty much limitless. I'll toss a link in the description so you can go create your own combo, And thanks to Dbrand for sponsoring this video. One of my biggest pet peeves with the Google Pixel 2 is that the whole premise behind Android is that it can accomplish more than other operating systems. Remember that iconic commercial from 8 years ago? Droid does. But yet here we have a phone directly from Google with Google's operating system, and it's plugging along with the bare minimum features of last year's iPhone 7, which is terrible, because iPhones are normally 2 or 3 years behind Android as it is. No wireless charging, no second camera, no headphone jack, bare minimum IP67 water resistance compared to LG's and Samsung's 68 level, and no expandable memory. Seriously, might as well just buy an iPhone at this point. Droid does, but this phone does not. Google just built a phone that goes against everything Android used to stand for. I did draw a pumpkin though, so that's kinda cool. Here's the SIM card tray with no SD card slot, and all the sides of the phone are coated in that same hybrid paint. It does feel good, don't get me wrong, but if you want metal, this isn't it. It might feel as though I'm roasting the Google Pixel a little during this video, and you're right, they are getting a little burned at the moment. I feel like the king of Android phones should be leading the pack. And even if we are reaching the end of the headphone jack era, that's still no reason to not include the plethora of other features that this phone lacks. It took about 15 seconds for the OLED display of the Pixel 2 to turn white and turn off, and never recover. That's 5 seconds longer than the LG V30 yesterday, but the V30 slaughters the Pixel in every other aspect, spec-wise. And finally, adding injury to insult, we have the bin test. The very first flex splits the back housing of the phone completely down the side. Looking closely, we can see that Google put an antenna line at the historically weakest point on every cell phone. This is where the iPhone 6 bent. This is also where the Nexus 6P snapped in half. And Google decided to make the weak spot even weaker with a plastic antenna line, right in the middle of the metal frame. Not sure why. This phone is definitely not skinny jean approved. And we also just lost all the water resistance of the phone. Not that IP67 was much to brag about in the first place. Bending from the other side of the phone is quite a bit more sturdy, and the phone does still function. It's not catastrophically damaged, so it won't end up on my shelf of shame, but still, not impressive. Not only might it absorb the color from your denim jeans, it could crack if you sit on the frame. I'd say a case or a skin is mandatory this time around, especially if you want the phone to last a few years. Remember, I'm a hardware guy. I'll leave the software to other reviewers, but for me and myself, I'll be sticking with a feature-rich Android phone that can do more. I'll be voting with my wallet, and this phone is not for me. Do you care about the features that Google left out? Let me know what you think in the comments, and don't forget to design your own Google Pixel using Dbrand's link in the video description. Come hang out with me on Twitter and Instagram, and hit that subscribe button to see the teardown of the Google Pixel coming soon. Thanks a ton for watching, and I'll see you around.